Okay, let's be honest here. Fashion has not exactly been in the forefront. I mean, a lot of people joke that they're dressing from the waist up.
Yes.
But fashion designer Frankie Lewis of Project Runway fame says there's a new trend to follow. And I have to also say, Frankie, otherwise known as Francis Lewis, when I first met you as a graduating high schooler, you're a Louisville native. You are a big advocate for the Cabbage Patch Settlement House.
Yes.
How are you doing in the midst of all of this?
I'm exhausted. I'm definitely exhausted. I'm doing the best I can, of course. I know we're all mentally struggling for our own different reasons. So it's good that we still have things like this so we can just have a little levity, you know, when we and take a break from all the seriousness that's happening right now.
Now, the Great Day Live team said that I'm not allowed to use the word levity because I think for the first like 2 months of COVID, but you can.
Okay.
Because I would feel like I would need to say this is for levity, but it's true.
Yeah.
We need the levity. We need a little bit of the fluffy stuff.
Yeah.
But also, I mean, I know a lot of people who are still, for the most part, not out and about. And I mean, we've forgotten that we can have fun with fashion.
Mm-hmm. And I mean, you have to come up for air. You just have to come up for air. So these moments, like yesterday, I shared one of John Legend's new videos, and it was just so beautiful because it's just videos of people coming together during this specific time. And, you know, this is our moment of we're deep diving, swimming deep in this crazy ocean, but we have to come up for air. We're humans. We have to breathe. So things like this just give us a chance to take a deep breath.
Okay. So dare I ask, because I mean, we're kind of on that roller coaster where like we're reemerging and there's a lot of things that are happening. I mean, the Kentucky Derby is going to be running and there's a lot of different parts. I know. We'll have to come back another time to talk about that
Yes.
But when it comes to, I mean, being out and about and finally just going, oh yeah, I can wear something other than workout gear. Well, in terms of summer fashion trends, what are you seeing?
Well, the mask is here to stay. That's for sure. It is not going anywhere. And as the CDC keeps updating its guidelines on what's acceptable, we're starting to see masks made out of all kinds of things. So right now, that's the trend that everybody's kind of focusing on because we can't really do without it. We can't run away from it. So I've been seeing a lot more people focusing on personalization of their mask, whether it's through words. You know, there's a lot of masks that are going around right now that say, I can't breathe, to support the protest. You know, different colors, matching your outfits. A friend of mine runs a company and her mask match her pet collars that she makes. So it's really about personalizing this thing that we cannot get away from that is affecting all of us. But yeah, masks are the new trend.
I mean, I love that. I mean, there are some, like you said, that are they're making a statement about what's happening in our world. Then there are others, some that kind of creep me out, where they have like the fake smile.
The fake face, yes. Oh my goodness. And then poor Kerry Washington, she has one with that weird mouth that she does when she's really acting.
She has one. There are some of them that say things, some of which I can't say out loud.
Yes.
They live to remind people to back it up.
Well, it's interesting because the mask is so multifaceted, so to speak, because it can be as casual as a T-shirt, because we all have those graphic tees with funny sayings or not safe for work sayings on them, right? But you also are seeing masks that have sparkles on them and glitz and glam. So the same thing you would see if you were going to the Speedball or a Met Gala mask. So it's really interesting that it's everyone has access to mask fashion at this point. There's no, oh, well, because at first it was all about, it's got to be the N95, it's got to be this, it's got to be that. And now that it's almost anything, people are getting real creative.
Okay, so speaking of creative, we followed you on Project Runway.
Yes.
Everyone who knows you has watched you go from, someone who grew up and benefited from the Cabbage Patch, of course, mm-hmm. a nonprofit that's well-known in Louisville, and then go on to become this local fashion designer that was much sought after. You're throwing your own fashion shows, and then, boom, you're on national TV on Project Runway. So what about you? I mean, I know you're making masks for you know, give out at the protests, and we'll talk about your Covered and Confident endeavor in just a moment. But what is the ultimate fashion Frances Lewis, Frankie Lou mask that you envision?
Well, you said the ultimate Frankie Lou mask that I envision.
Oh, absolutely. I mean, one that like, we're stepping out in this.
Yes.
I have to step out in the backyard. Yes.
So I've become really obsessed with designing denim masks because everyone loves a good pair of jeans. You know, it's there's no one in this world that doesn't have a pair of jeans that they love in their closet. And so coming up with denim masks to go with your favorite pair of jeans, that's something that's been really exciting me now. But I'm also interested in like these artistic masks just for the sake of the visual pleasure that they give, not for their function. You know, there's some, there's always some level of art that has nothing to do with function. So I'm also playing around with those as well.
I know when people are just like, oh, I can't stand to wear the mask. I think I saw somebody, it was a, you know, ripping your mask off after going to the grocery store is removing your undergarments, you know.
Yes, it is. It is.
That makes me laugh. But I have noticed, you know, there are people have masks and it's just kind of nice because you can't tell that you're smiling unless you're smizing with your eyes there, you know, you're smiling.
It's genuine. There are no fake smiles in a mask. There's no fake smile in a mask. You have to be genuinely happy in order to make that shine through.
Oh, for sure. But I also kind of appreciate, I'm like, oh, well, I don't have to do makeup here. And here.
Yes, yes.
Give myself a little break. Okay, so confidentandcovered.com. That's your newest endeavors.
So Confident and Covered is something that I thought of when all of this COVID mess broke out and I was back home, you know, stranded here a little bit, visiting family, just unknown and what's going on. And I'm a deeply religious person. And I remember when I was on my way to Project Runway, I was driving across country alone, and I had all this time to think about all my insecurities and all my stresses and what I was getting into. And as I was listening to music and praying and trying to like calm myself down, there was a song lyric that struck me. And part of that lyric was Confident and Covered by the power of your great love. So when you go to Confident and Covered, the point isn't confidence in ourselves, because right now, strong. But the good news is that we don't have to be, because if you are a believer, then you have God. If not, we still have each other. We have our neighbors. We have our community. So you can be confident that you are loved, confident that you are cared for, and confident that you're covered.
Well, I love that, Frankie. Always love talking to you. Like I said, I'll invite you back for a derby.
Please.
I'm excited about that. To connect with Frankie, you can follow her on Instagram. Her handle is Frankie_Lou. I'm going to spell that for you. I know it's on the screen, but that's FrankieLewW. Or visit FrankieLewW.com. And again, that's Frankie, FrankieLewW.com. Or visit ConfidentAndCovered.com.